Tails.
It's a snooker occasion to savour for sure. Two players adored for their dazzling natural talent, their ability to fill arenas with their unique brand of brilliance. Huge mutual respect. What do we have in store? Clearly, the Whirlwind is the underdog. The Rocket, mightily impressive in his first round, scoring heavily.
Thank you. The first frame.
But admitting to feeling just a little nervous ahead of this match in playing one of his boyhood idols.
Yes, it's a different kind of a match for both of these guys, isn't it? And it'll be a test of, I think, both of their concentration, because they're not used to Jimmy's not used to wanting to see Ronnie miss a ball because he always supports him, and vice versa. But unfortunately, they're playing for their living here. So we're playing a serious snooker match between two of the great players of the game. One certainly still up there now, and that Jimmy White, well, he's still got it in him, hasn't he? Let's see how he goes tonight. I think he certainly won't be fazed by the big crowd. He'll rise to that occasion.
Yes, it's a testament to Jimmy White's continued love of this game that a full two decades and more after he reached the last of his six World Championship finals, he's still out there competing, still believing that he can produce the old magic.
Yes, we've got the Chinese teenager still in this tournament, which is Zhu Yulong, and he's playing John Higgins. But Jimmy White turned professional 36 years ago, Ronnie, back in 1992. There's a lot of snooker in that time they've both played. And they've both done it in the same way. They've both one and they've entertained in the process. Never dull, never boring. Playing safe here, he's got to be a little careful, Jimmy, because black is kind of in the way of potentially playing on the way down or on the way back up. He's managed to avoid it and he's weighted it very nicely. It's a good shot, covered off the right side of the table, blocked that one off, and a safety shot from Ronnie. He's got to be swinging the cue ball around with right hand side, could get him behind the green.
O'Sullivan chasing his 29th career ranking title this week. Were he to win on Sunday evening, he would go into second place on his own behind Stephen Hendry in the all-time list. Jimmy White, one of the few players to have won 10 or more ranking titles. The first of those, incredibly, 30 years ago at the Classic, when he needed a snooker in the final frame to deny Cliff Thorburn. A lot of snooker water under the bridge since then.
Well, I think he was forced into the pot there. He couldn't really see a safety shot. And if you don't see one, you may as well go for a pot if there's one available. There it is. He got close to it. I don't know that he's left anything particularly easy from that miss. And Already Ronnie needing the extension out to even reach a red. Never mind pot one.
So first blood to the rocket with a good pot with the extension on the rest, never easy.
Yes, I think just about get to the yellow here, that's about all he can do. Blue is covered by the red, which he's now going to pot. Because the black is tied up, so he's got to work hard to make this into a break, and no one is better at creating an opening than Ronnie, in that within a few shots he always plays the key strategy shot to make the break happen.
Four.
Well, that's got lovely pace on it. Goodness me, he couldn't have hit that better. He could go into the bunch to get the black into play. He doesn't have to. Well, that was a little bit nervy, even to hit the pink full on. Didn't really do any damage there.
Nine.
As you see, I mean, he's quite a way off from what he tried. He didn't mean that. Well, a huge roar would remind everyone that while this match means an awful lot to the people watching, Jordan Brown and Kyron Wilson are in action on another table. Jordan Brown is an Northern Irish player. So there's a few people over there as well. It's like a cauldron in here tonight.
Yes, and Liang Wenbo, who of course won the first leg of the brand new Home Nations, is playing Mark King on the neighbouring table too. Liang, who still theoretically at least could bag that £1 million bonus. He's only got to win this one and two more in Glasgow and in Cardiff next year. But there's no question the majority 15. Of the crowd tonight are here to see these two legends of the Green Bays go head-to-head for perhaps, as Ronnie mentioned, the final time. Who knows how much longer Jimmy will continue to play. The answer, I think, 16. Neil, is for as long as he enjoys it, and he clearly still does.
Loves playing snooker, loves practicing, enjoys the buzz. Nights like this make it all worthwhile, I think. This is a very difficult break. I mean, the second time he's had to resort to playing the yellow when high value colours are somewhat in play. And he's not got the usual immaculate 18. Control of the cue ball in this break. It's most unlike Ronnie. One of the hardest 18 breaks I think I've ever seen him make this. Once again, goes 19. Up for another bolt colour. Unheard of. His earlier effort to go into the bunch was a mile away. Now, there is a red that goes here. Could develop a few more in the process of pulling this one. He's pushed a red near the middle pocket, which helps. He can use that one up as a reserve red if he doesn't get on to the next one. No, certainly didn't play to finish where he has, but of course he's got the wonderful advantage of being such a good player left-handed, he can reach this easily. That was a nervy little break of 29.
29.
And I understand why.
Well, we've heard that refrain a few hundred thousand times down the years. Come on, Jimmy. Looks like he's got an easy starter at least.
One.
When you put topspin on that shot, the cue ball, it kind of spins back off the cushion, never goes very far. If you could have stunned it, it could have got up the table even further.
Ping ball.
Well, that's a great shot. Played with a lot of right-hand side. Straightened the cue ball up, but the pot had to go in as well.
Now, seven.
Here we see it again. The cue ball fizzed back towards the red, and it only just went in that pink. He needs to be topside of the blue and get into the bunch, try the shot that Ronnie failed on.
Eight.
I think he's got a particularly big angle on this blue from there as well. Difficult shot to break the bunch. So onto the loose red, but now his position on the next colour has to be bang on.
13.
The whirlwind looking very trim these days. He's lost an awful lot of weight in the last few months.
Well, that is absolutely perfect. Now, when Ronnie played this, he hit the pink full ball. Can Jimmy play it any better? It's almost a carbon copy of the shot that his opponent was left. And the reds haven't really moved since. And obviously the pink is in the way. A bit of tension in the arm, he'll go into it himself.
14.
Played it well. Could have had a better result, though. He's got a thin red only.
19.
Could have been kinder. But there haven't been many better players in the history of this game with the rest than Jimmy White. What an occasion. Every seat taken. Tremendous atmosphere, a real buzz around the place.
Thank you.
20. Well, once again, not quite as he'd like on a colour, but as a left-hander, he could probably punch the yellow around the table or whatever it is to get down onto the only red that sticks out.
No prizes for guessing who the lady centre picture is supporting this evening. And there are millions who feel the same way.
Well, he thinks that the green takes him down the centre of the table. Got a heavy contact there, I think. It's been a real struggle for both players, the breaks that they've made here.
And it's again.
Was that really opened up very kindly yet?
24.
Well, let's see how this break can go on much longer unless he plays some sort of a flashy shot on the green to open the bunch. If he pots the blue, he can't get on the reds. There is a possibility that one might go to the left corner, the top one. Very thoughtful Jimmy White. He's not rushing in this break.
Yellow ball.
So a safety shot here.
Jimmy White, 24.
It's okay. You'd expect Ronnie O'Sullivan to lay into this little bunch of four reds. It's all about the pace. It's a good shot, that. Played it really well. Only thing I would say is that Jimmy again should put distance between the cue ball and the little bunch of four reds here. Could go either way this frame. At the moment, Jimmy just holding the aces when it comes to the tactical side. He's got Ronnie on the ropes slightly. And he's faced with a pretty horrible shot here. He doesn't really want to open these reds up. He doesn't know where they're going to go. That's why he's played the shot he has.
...59 still on the table, just 5 points between them. Very competitive opening frame.
Chance to get in behind the yellow here. I think that's what he tried.
Mistake from O'Sullivan, chance for White.
It is, Philip. It's actually one of those shots that is not simple that he's left there. A bit of an acute angle. I think on that camera angle, it looks like it's almost hanging over the middle pocket, but it's not quite.
Don't touch the yellow, Jimmy, whatever you do.
Played it well.
One.
So that little safety jewel's won by the whirlwind. Now he's just got to convert this chance and win the frame from it. And there was some doubt as to whether both of those reds were potable. If the top one, the right-hand one of the two goes, really this opens it up. This is now a golden chance. And that
eight
was a nervy shot. Again, he may have got a bad contact, but I've seen him hit the ball more smoothly as well.
Didn't seem to get into the cue ball as he wanted.
He played it with right hand side and he's recovered.
15.
There's always something awkward though when the pressure's on, and this red that he's playing doesn't really want to hit the black on the way through. It's kind of a natural to go into it. He's going to screw it. And he's avoided that. It's a good shot.
16.
That's the best shot he's played tonight. And it was well struck.
And disagreeing.
Could have easily gone in behind the pink, but he hit it just that little bit harder. He hasn't quite got centre ball striking on this red. He'd have to be play with it. I think it's just a touch of side, unwanted side.
24.
Lead goes to 19. Job not done yet.
No, brown and yellow would mean that Ronnie could still tie the frame, because blue onto the yellow would be enough, but it's a more difficult shot to get the blue onto the yellow. It's all around the table. Jimmy feeling the pressure. He knows that he's almost, if he's got any hopes of winning this match, he's got to start well and win frames of this kind. And anyone who doubted that this would be anything but a real contest between two snooker players trying their hardest, they've only got to look at the way that Jimmy's trying here. He's trying as if his life depended on it, and that's what you expect from these guys. Brilliant shot. Now, only the yellow needed.
29.
Yes, they may be great friends off the table, but it would be a huge thrill for the whirlwind if he could put one over the rocket tonight. And he's made a very encouraging start. This frame is safe, barring snookers.
I said that both players' opening contributions in this frame were a little nervy. This has not been nervy. This has been
34.
Nerveless stuff and sheer determination. He knows he's got a game on now.
Foul. Jimmy White, 34. Win your Sullivan, 4.
Well, Jimmy has always cued so low down on the cue ball. It's been his trademark right from the get-go.
Well, I can't believe he played it like that. I mean, now he only wants one snooker. He knows he's made a mistake. I'm just looking over at Jimmy. He's really disappointed. Of course, when you do that, you can knock a chunk out of your tip. That would be a further dimension to a match we didn't expect. No. However, he's okay.
Yeah. Not a great shot from O'Sullivan, so relief for the whirlwind. It's looking like 1-0. Pink is academic. Jimmy White is a big underdog tonight against Rocket Ronnie O'Sullivan, but he's made a very good start, and that's what the crowd think about it. First blood to the whirlwind. He leads by a frame to nil, but there's a long way to go. Two snooker legends going head-to-head in front of a capacity crowd here in Belfast at the Northern Ireland Open, and it's first blood to the 54-year-old whirlwind of London Town, Jimmy White. A classy break of 34, getting him to the snooker's required stage. The following miscue on the brown didn't prove costly. O'Sullivan needed a couple of snookers, but couldn't get them. So, a good start for the veteran.
I think Jimmy had any other shot there. He's invited Ronnie to play the red down the table and push it back up towards the others. And Ronnie's played that very well. He's covered both sides. In fact, he might have just a thin edge that he can get to past the blue. Dangerous shot to play with the red out on the right-hand side of the table, but that is a measured safety shot back.
Couldn't have played that much better. The green providing cover for that loose red. He's up for this tonight. You can just tell Jimmy is seriously psyched up for this rare opportunity to take on his great mate. They play countless exhibitions together, of course, but a competitive match like this in a major ranking event in front of a big crowd is something rather different. Well, you can feel the buzz around the place.
Well, he might not want that one back. It's so the little raising of the right hand, just to say, well, I got lucky there. Double kissing on that red. Somehow he's finished in bulk. Ronnie didn't particularly fancy that shot the way that he played it. Hit the cue ball back as well. Jimmy might have to play another similar attacking shot here. Guiding of the cue ball was the best part about that shot. Well, he might have wished he had gone for one, because that was with check side, a shot not hit hard enough. Also, he caught the red a bit thick.
Sullivan traditionally has been deadly in this kind of situation, getting in early.
Eight.
In amongst the reds, black available, normally spells trouble with a capital T for his opponent.
Nine.
A chance to just free the two reds above the black here. Little nudge, perfectly judged. And they're both potable.
16. 17.
Well, that wasn't one of his best. He went straight to
24.
The red to right corner. Well recovered.
25. Thirty-one.
Well, surely not. He's just on this. For a second, it looked as if the red was going to come in the way.
38. 39.
Doesn't have to go into the little bunch of four reds. One of them goes, the right hand red. That's what he's played on.
46. 47. 54. 55.
Still a bit of work to do.
62. 63.
75 available. So one, a further red after this black. Look how he's got on that. Tremendous.
70. 71.
And there was an air of inevitability about this from the moment that White made the safety error. That's how good O'Sullivan is. Absolutely deadly. When he's in amongst them,
76.
As good as ever.
77.
23 years ago that he won the first of those 28 ranking titles. Still 16 years of age when he stunned Stephen Hendry and announced himself as a quite extraordinary talent.
84.
And the longevity that he's 85. Produced in this game, despite the strength in depth these days, is... well, remarkable. Still, at his best, the man to beat. Perhaps not the best 92. Right now. John Higgins has been on fire, as we know, the maximum 93. Man from earlier. Beat Ronnie in the final of the Champion of Champions, but you've got to think it's only a matter of time before he's lifting a big prize again. It might well be this 98. Week in Belfast. This is certainly...
99.
The proper response to losing that tight opening frame.
106.
Century number 838.
107.
Well, it's not been easy, this break. There have been moments when he struggled, but the way he started to cue towards the end, I mean, the last red and that black there. It's fabulous ball striking.
114.
Both frames have taken a similar pattern in that...
116.
Jimmy was in a spot of trouble. And Ronnie has taken full advantage of it.
119.
First frame in reverse. Jimmy won the safety battle. No huge breaks. But really, the scoring power of O'Sullivan is better than almost anybody. I say almost, because John Higgins is still playing and scoring very big. But this has been a great break.
128.
And it's not been going 7 minutes yet. Made a 1-3-1 clearance in just over 5.5 minutes against David John in the first round as the whirlwind watches on. What a break that was. Sheer brilliance from Ronnie O'Sullivan to level this match. A sublime clearance of 141. And battle is well and truly joined here at the Titanic Exhibition Centre. O'Sullivan won. White won. Clash of two of snooker's titans down the years. And it's been a pretty encouraging start. A good opening frame from Jimmy White. But what a response from Ronnie O'Sullivan. A quite magnificent 141 clearance to level the match. The first of four, of course, to go through to the round of 32 tomorrow. Both the last 32 and the last 16 rounds to be played on Thursday.
Not, Not an easy shot, that one. And hitting it too thick, because the black goes to the opposite corner. Once again, Mike Target trying to get in behind the brown here on this safety shot. It's a little bit heavy-handed, leaving another similar red to the one that Jimmy just played to that right corner if he wants it.
Close.
Anticipation here amongst the audience. Interesting point, you know, that Ronnie O'Sullivan said pre-match when they were both
touching ball,
asked what they thought about this match, because they've played it before a number of times. Ronnie actually said this could be the last time, and of course there's always that possibility. It was his words, and of course we hope he's not right, but who knows if these two will meet in this sort of, on this sort of stage again in their careers. It's not happened recently. Last time they played in a ranking event was 2010. They played in 2011 in the Premier League. No doubt played a number of exhibitions since then, but this is the big stage.
Opening red.
Yes, Philip, very well played, because if he missed that, he was doing no damage, and of course now that it's gone in, he's on the brown perfectly. Didn't go in cleanly, but it went in.
5. Six.
Well, Jimmy not rushing, he's looking at every option. Reds were not very well placed, actually, for a scoring visit. He's managed to find one that goes here at the top of the bunch.
12.
There it is. He'll need to go into them at some point. So, top side of the blue to make that happen, I think. Well, he's a little straight on this. He has a slight angle. 13. Right on the black spot is available. Certainly the one at the bottom of the bunch is a possibility as well. Something goes.
18.
Well, there's that one. In fact, it's that one that goes, the last I mentioned. Question of what he can do with it. You have to go into the reds. How can he get on the colour? Certainly the reds should scatter here. He really hit that hard. And that's very unlucky.
19.
He's got here is he's probably got to play the green if he's going to play safe. He wouldn't really want to move that ball because it's obviously covering that red to the right middle where it is, but unless he can hit the brown half ball and play over that side of the table, there is something interesting as if he could possibly get to the blue.
Blue ball.
He's playing around two cushions in behind the blue here. Played it behind it.
Could have had more fortune with that forcing shot into the cluster of reds, which left him out of position. And this red goes for O'Sullivan.
1.
Well, if you're sitting in your chair like Jimmy White there, you've got to see a bit of body language as to whether William Sullivan is on the black. He's not, by the looks of things, not playing ball. So he's got to try and just hit as much as he can.
If he had been, it could well have been 2-1 in a couple of minutes.
William Sullivan, 1.
As it is, White with an 18-point lead.
It's one if Ronnie's got a double to the right middle here. I don't know if he has. He'll certainly be looking to get the cue ball safe. Reds are very inviting if a chance is left. Don't think he's played the double. Played the cue ball underneath that cushion so that it's quite difficult for Jimmy to get to play the screw shot back to there. Quite a good shot. Wow, what a misjudgment that was.
And a miss.
Goodness me. Referee will be hoping.
2-4.
Jimmy doesn't have these put back because couple of Reds moves that he could never have been looking at where they were. There is something to the middle pocket. Well, he's putting it back. Good luck with this one. And they're having the cue ball cleaned, actually.
Sullivan very lucky not to have left something rather easier. I mean, it's a relatively straightforward red, but could easily have left Jimmy a really short range one to get on the black.
One.
Oh, that's a horrible kiss. That is the worst scenario. From look at all those colours lined up, but the kiss. On the way through like that, that's put things into a few problems here. I mean, he probably can play a fairly negative safety shot, but he really saw this as a chance.
Anywhere but there.
Green ball. Jimmy White, one.
It's been an absolutely sensational break. A total clearance of 1-for-1 in the previous frame. But other than that, it's safe to say that Jimmy White has more than played his part in the first 2.5 frames. He's competing.
Foul.
It wasn't until that shot, I'm afraid. It was like one of the old long Jenny billiard shots there.
Only 1-4.
But with the cue ball going in, that could prove very costly indeed.
Things looking inviting for O'Sullivan at the business end of the table. White ruining that mistake.
Well, a good shot to play on the blue to get it back on its own spot. And also a good shot to play on that red. Typical O'Sullivan. It was a an opportunity, but he's already got things working how he wants them. The table is at his mercy now, within two shots.
Seven.
Well, how's that gone wrong?
Well, it was a very surprising shot. He went into them and I don't think he's on anything.
14.
Well, that's a major let-off for Jimmy White, if indeed it is to be end of break. Looks that way. Just the safety. O'Sullivan not impressed with his positional shot on that occasion. Seemed to have done the hard work in just a couple of shots. That's what he thinks about it. Really tense out there, you can feel it, can't you? I guess it's a rather strange match for this pair because it is so long since they did battle competitively, as Neil mentioned, 5 years ago and counting, and they are such good friends, so close off the table. Sullivan, of course, heavily expected to win. He's certainly not having things all his own way so far, even though he did make that fantastic clearance in frame two.
Certainly going towards the red at the other end of the table was not part of the plan. It could have been worse. Oh, what a shot. Again, the cue ball was always heading in behind the green, but he really cued that well. This is not going to be a particularly nice snooker for Jimmy White to hit.
And Sullivan, one.
Minute frame and still bags of reds on the table.
Oh, that's way off. That is way off the mark.
Ball, Nimis, Ronnie O'Sullivan, six.
Well, I'm not sure what he's playing. I think he's probably trying to hit the red on the right of the table on the cushion. Get past the pink and play around two cushions and hit that red that's currently safe, but it really was a misjudgment. And now Ronnie has an opportunity, and this is the best one of the frame.
But again, not as intended.
Now, I must say one thing. Eight. The table does seem a little heavy tonight. The balls are making a real noise when they're hitting each other, but they're not reacting very well. The cue ball's not zipping around. So that's a real surprise.
Can
that
you make
many
eight.
More there. Just eight from that. What was obviously a good chance.
Two gilt-edged opportunities for the Rocket in this frame, but just a 10-point lead to show for it.
I'm pretty sure he did play that. Obviously, safety was part of that, but I think he had a look to see if the red would pass the pink.
Green ball.
Not looking to defend here. Playing the green and up the table for the next red. Jaws in the middle pocket. Might have come to his rescue here. Well, he won't mind that result.
Four.
Sullivan looking a little rueful. He had those two very good chances to potentially carve out a frame-winning break, as he so often does when he's given an opportunity like the ones he's had here. These are the kind of frames that you feel the Whirlwind has to win tonight if he is to spring an upset. Won the first frame. Well, they'll be disappointed with that one.
Jimmy White, four.
So, a very scrappy affair this third frame.
Yes, and of course, there's certainly a red that will go to the right corner. The one just out from the cushion will pass the pink. Yep, only just, but it will pass. It's a great shot.
One.
Not a lot of room there.
So, a third Seven. Opportunity for O'Sullivan to take the lead for the first time.
Eight.
Well, he's going to need both reds.
Sixteen.
And he just wriggled in. Off the far jaw.
Well, he's just got to play in behind this red nicely. Doesn't want to have to do a lot more than pot this. He wouldn't really want to be knocking it in and getting onto a colour. As it happens, the angle takes him out away from the cushion anyway. It's a frame ball. And 24. Should be enough to win frame three.
Yes, and it will be frustrating for White as regards the manner in which he's lost this one. Relatively straightforward red to left centre, which hit the jaw. And this is the result.
31.
His good friend punishing him for that mistake. Well, the yellow stays out.
31.
But Jimmy, who's distracted for a moment, belatedly holds up his hand to say no. Don't fancy playing on for snookers there. So, a very scrappy, bitty frame. A frame that's gone the way of Rocket Ronnie O'Sullivan, who now leads the Whirlwind 2-1. He's shown enough tonight to suggest he can.
What a shot that is. Okay, he's not very nicely on the black. So it's basically 1 point. Of course, an interesting aspect to this match, I would say, is the players' average shot times. Ronnie O'Sullivan is always in the teens, 17 at the moment, 17 seconds per shot. Jimmy's 29 seconds a shot. And of course, he's known as the whirlwind, but he's putting a lot of concentration into this. There's this confirmation. For Jimmy White, that is slow, but it's such an occasion that he's putting everything into it, I think. Ronnie has his usual speed, just ticking along nicely. Such a good effort. I tell you, he's so close hitting that red.
Can you put that back down, please?
He'll be getting another opportunity as well.
Back.
Someone getting a bit restless in the audience, I think.
Cue ball returns to its original position. Sullivan will have another chance to just flick off the red. Two cushions.
Difficult shot, Philip, where the... where the cue ball is over the top of the green to get the side right. Very minor adjustment. He nearly hit it last time.
Foul, and a miss. Jimmy White, four.
And of course, O'Sullivan can have as many goes of this as he likes because he's snookered on all reds. No issue of having to hit one at the third attempt or risk forfeiting the frame, which would be the case if he could see a red. Well, applause, but much thicker than intended, so this is an early opportunity for Jimmy.
One.
Yes, that very slight adjustment to get the contact with the red. When they hit him thicker than he wanted to, he almost had to keep playing the shot the way he was and hope to just glance it, I think. It won't leave such a fair opportunity as this one to Jimmy. Well, he's certainly taking his time. He's looking at all his options here.
Yeah, I mean, clearly Jimmy's nowhere near as brisk as he used to be back in his whirlwind days, but this is a big occasion for him, bigger than it is for Ronnie. Let's be honest about this. We don't know how many more opportunities the 54-year-old is going to have to play a match of this gravitas against a player like Ronnie O'Sullivan. He wants to savour it. He wants to give it everything he's got, and if that means taking his time, well, so be it. And O'Sullivan just needs to cope with that.
Well, the good thing about this match from my point of view is that these two guys, we know they're great friends, lifelong friends, but they're playing here as if their life depends on it, and that is sport. Friendships go out of the window. It has to be that way. There's no other way to play a competitive sport than that. He'll be most disappointed to finish there.
15.
He can certainly get to the red to the left middle, the one on the left of the bunch, but my word, that's a difficult shot. And all safety shots are not very easy either. So he's going to go red to the right middle, even more difficult. Always near jaw, but always stayed there. Great shot, great recovery. The disappointment The finishing there was something he got over fairly quickly. Wow, what an opportunity this is.
Twenty-two. 23.
Bit of adrenaline in that one, I fancy. Overhit it by a good 4 or 5 inches. Making position on the next red that much trickier.
Well, it was a good shot to get the cue ball 25. Into that direction, but of course you need a bit of luck. And a red up to the top right pocket is probably the best you could hope for here. Ronnie just a bit restless there, just waiting for something to happen, waiting for his chance to get back to the table.
It was mighty 25. Close, but just too far towards the near jaw, or rather the far jaw, to drop. I think for a moment White thought that was in.
One.
So O'Sullivan can now dictate the pace of play. He's back in. Got a bit of work to do, playing catch up in this frame, but the lead is relatively modest and that will evaporate very quickly.
Six.
If O'Sullivan does what he normally does in this situation.
Seven.
Yes, he's been patient sitting there and hoping for this chance to come, and as you say, he's now got a chance to make things happen. And all the time it took, Jimmy never really got all that far in front, did he, in that
14.
Break. And of course it'll hurt his great friend Ronnie O'Sullivan more by scoring heavily than
15.
He's taking time at the table. Nicely played little nudge.
21. Twenty-two. 29. 30.
Well, he's got past the black spot, which was crucial there.
37. 38.
Still absolutely lethal in amongst them, isn't he? As we saw with that 141 total clearance in frame two.
40. Well, by Ronnie O'Sullivan's standards, it may have been a slightly frustrating season 45. So far. He's yet to win a title, but he has made two finals, got within a frame of winning one at the European Masters. Only
46.
A superb finish from Judd Trump denied him. And of course, a brilliant performance from John Higgins in the Champion of Champions final to win the last three frames after a very competitive duel earlier in the match.
53.
Most players will be delighted with that kind 54. Of consistency, but of course for O'Sullivan, it's all about winning trophies.
Well, red and a black means he doesn't need the red along the cushion.
60.
Goodness me, that was a really poor shot. To finish down there, I wouldn't be surprised. Well, most players, I think, would just roll this in. Not Ronnie's style particularly, but I think on this occasion, you have to play to the scoreboard, and that's what he's done.
He was trying to do the number crunching there and perhaps had a bit of a brain freeze, but he is over the winning line, barring a snooker. It is just the one snooker, however.
Daniel Sullivan, 68.
So, of course, White will return. That 68 could prove to be enough, though, to put O'Sullivan 2 up with 3 to play.
One thing you can say about this match here, Philip, anyone that doubted that this would be played anything but ultra competitively would have got it very wrong. Jimmy has been trying his hardest, taking his time on shots. Ronnie has looked a little frustrated at times, but we saw from that last shot on the black, he made sure of the black, no crowd shots. It took him 36 in front. This is a serious game of snooker.
Well, you never lose those competitive instincts, do you? Jimmy White may be coming towards the end of his career, but the ambition to triumph is still burning brightly. He's clearly not the force he once was. And let's not forget, he's 13 years O'Sullivan senior as well. He's trying his heart out. Just the one snooker needed. But it's O'Sullivan who's got one. Hits the red, but this frame is surely over now.
One. Five. Seven. Ten. Fourteen. Nineteen.
19. The break of 68 that did the damage for the 5 times world champion. And Jimmy White's task now, well, steep, to put it mildly. He trails O'Sullivan 3-1. Ronnie O'Sullivan, he's produced patches of brilliance this evening, not least that 141 clearance, a break of 68 in the frame just completed. One or two errors as well. It's been quite a tense match. Jimmy taking his time. Ronnie eager to get on with it, as he always is. Can White extend this match to at least one further frame? He's not played badly, but he's got a lot to do now.
About to play the shot, and maybe a bit of his tip has just flaked off, and he's it was in his eye line. It's not an easy one, this opener. Didn't quite know where the keeper was going to finish. And he saw what I mean. One of the few places that he's not on the black, pink to the middle. Well, it might not be a fanciful shot, but he still might play it. Can get to the middle of the cue ball on this. That's such a good shot. Really solidly struck that.
Made a tough shot.
Seven.
Look easy. Is this the beginning of the end for Jimmy?
Eight.
Well, that's not gone according to plan. This is a much tougher blue than he wanted. Perhaps he'll go for the green instead.
Yes, he certainly didn't hit the red very cleanly. He nearly missed it. The direction was all wrong. And it adds some extra pressure on this shot.
Eleven.
Two great shots.
Twelve.
Plenty of other action, of course, going on, even though this is very much the main event of the evening for the crowd. Zhang Ander coming through against Chris Wakelin by the odd frame. And he'll now play John Higgins as O'Sullivan presses the pink. Well, that is a surprise. Of course, Higgins, the star of the show today with that brilliant maximum break. Well, that is a surprise. He cued across it.
Yes, because Zhang Ander does play the winner of this match, and that will be an occasion as well. Might be quite up there with this one.
Zhang Ander, who nearly surprised Stephen Hendry back in the day at the Crucible in the first round. He was two up with three to play. Hendry managing to fight back to win in the decider. It's probably one of his more memorable matches as a pro so far.
One.
Still very good with that rest, isn't he?
He hit that one beautifully, and again, the invitation is there to go into the pyramid of six reds almost in a perfect set there. But of course, he doesn't have to, because there's plenty of other reds available to him, and the shape of the bunch suggests he could just glance off them. So I can understand why he's played a different shot. And that's okay.
Six. Foul. Jimmy White, six.
Well,
Bruno Sullivan, four.
You can say unfortunate, I guess, for the white to disappear, but it shouldn't really have been near the pocket.
Well, I think he's probably just gone hit too low on the cue ball there. It was a stun shot, stun it in front of the middle pocket and up. It was a semi-screw shot and it threw wider. Wow, that was an absolute mile away. I don't know what happened there, whether his hand slipped or something. But I haven't seen Ronnie miss one like that before. I don't think ever. There's almost no way for him to understand what's happened there. A very concerned look on his face. And generally, his long game in the last year or so has been much better. Anyway, I'll put it down as a blip, I think.
One.
As competitive as Jimmy White has been so far, his highest break is a modest 34. If he is to get back into this, he's got to start scoring more heavily.
Jimmy White, 6. One.
Well, as usual, Ronnie playing on the difficult colour there, the black. Get it back onto its spot, get the ball rolling, so to speak, get the match 8. Won. Just flicked
9.
The pink on the way through, but he's on the pink. He played it on the blue there. He probably doesn't like the angle on the pink. It's absolutely dead straight. Of course, the angle on the blue is even worse in a way, coming away from the reds altogether. So the next pot is going to be at the kind of range that he just missed one by a mile to the opposite corner. In fact, it's a similar shot in reverse.
14.
This could be the end. It's been a great occasion, great night, lots of tension. The crowd have enjoyed it.
22.
They were in here long before play started to get the
23.
Best seats. But it might be coming to an end in the next few shots if Ronnie can just finish off the job here. Because he lost frame one and made a total clearance and has been ticking over since then without ever to his full capacity. And that is how to split the reds open.
That very much looks like
30.
Job done for O'Sullivan, barring something surprising. And it was always
31.
Likely to be more about the occasion tonight than the result. O'Sullivan, of course, was always going to be the red hot favourite. He's still at the very top of the game. Jimmy White coming towards the end of his illustrious
36.
Career. He's given it his very best shot this evening.
37.
He's had one or two chances that he'll perhaps regret he didn't make more of.
Three.
But it's one of those I was there moments, wasn't it, for the crowd, the opportunity 45. To see these two great players go head to head in a big ranking event back in Ireland. It's going to be O'Sullivan, though, who's going to book his place in the last 32. Jimmy,
52.
We'll have to make do with the studio.
Well, I expect a warm handshake or some sort of an embrace between 53. Those two guys. It's been a good match. O'Sullivan was in the same part of the draw, same quarter as John Higgins, who seems to be playing out of his skin right now. So that's going to be interesting.
60.
Not there yet.
61.
Zhang Ander is the man who is waiting for the winner of this match. And of course tomorrow there's the potential for guys to play twice. Play down to the end of tomorrow, there'll be 8 players left. So a busy day coming up. Ronnie O'Sullivan 70. Is a part of it.
Not enough points for a winning century for the Rocket. The break of 141 was spectacularly good to level the match at 1-1 after White had made a very promising start. He had chances 77. In the third frame, which was a scrappy, lengthy affair. But in the end, O'Sullivan's scoring power just too much for the whirlwind.
82.
Ronnie O'Sullivan finishes off, as he so often does, in style, with a clearance of the table. A break of 95. Jimmy started well, but couldn't sustain it. Ronnie O'Sullivan got stronger and has ultimately won with some comfort. But a great occasion for this capacity crowd. It's O'Sullivan who wins out 4-1.